To our YouTube channel Aisha Young IAS. In this series of short tricks, we will cover short tricks for most expected tough and time consuming questions. Okay, so today's topic is short tricks for finding smallest and largest fractions. Okay, so this type of questions are most expected in all competitions for SSC CGL, RRB, CGSL, etc. So let's get started. So to solving this type of questions, the basic logic is when the fraction is a by b and the answer the solution is k, as the value of a numerator increases, the value of k will increase, and as the value of denominator b will increase, similarly the value of k will decrease. Okay, though so the similar logic will be used in all type of questions which we are using. This is the simple logic which we have studied in our schools. So this logic will be used in all type of questions and most of the questions which we will be solving. Okay, so let's get started. So this is the first question which has appeared in SSC CGL 2003. Which of the following is the largest fraction? 6 by 7, 5 by 6, 7 by 8 and 4 by 5. Okay, so this type of questions can be easily solved in 5 seconds without touching your pen. So when you have numbers whose difference is similar, means all the numbers, the difference between the numerator and denominator is 1, difference between 6 and 7 is 1, difference between 5 and 6 is 1, difference between 7 and 8 is 1, and difference between 4 and 5 is 1. So when you have this kind of question, so the fraction which has the smallest value, like 4 by 5 has the smallest value among all the given options. Okay, so this will be option A, B, C and D. So the 4 by 5 D will be the answer. Okay, so this kind of questions you can directly solve by looking at the questions. You don't have to touch the pen to solve this kind of questions. Okay, so these are the easy 2 marks which you can easily achieve. Okay, so let's move to the next question. In this question, you have to find the smallest value among the fractions. Okay, so generally how people solve this question is convert the fraction into decimal form, and the which has the smallest value, the smallest decimal will be the fraction. But we do not have that much time to solve the questions, solve each and every decimal in the exam. So let's find it if there is any easier method to solve this kind of questions. So to solve this kind of question, the easier method is to cross multiply the fraction, like 7 into 9, 63, and 6 into 7, 42. So 63 is bigger than 42, then 7 by 6 is bigger than 7 by 9. Okay, similarly 7 by 9 and 4 by 5. 5 into 4, 35, and 9 into 4, 36. So 36 is bigger than 35. Similarly, we will do the same process for the last fractions. 7 into 4, 28, 5 into 5, 25. Okay, so this fraction is bigger in both the cases. Only we have to compare is this fraction and this fraction, because we do not have direct relations between them. So let's try for them. 7 by 9 and 5 by 7. Okay, 7 into 7 is 49 and 9 into 5 is 35. Okay, so like this, in 10 to 20 seconds you can solve this kind of questions. And these are the easiest questions in the number series, wherein you can easily solve the questions by, if you have enough amount of practice, you can directly solve the questions by looking at the questions. Okay, then so these are the easy marks which you can achieve on in your whichever competitions which you are participating. Okay, now we will move to the next question. It is easier to cross multiply when the value of the fraction is smaller. As you can see in this question, the value of fraction is smaller, so we can easily multiply that. But what will be the case when the value of the fractions, the numbers are bigger? How we can cross multiply and find the answer very easily? Now we have to find the smallest fraction among the series. The values are 15 by 16, 19 by 20, 24 by 25, 34 by 35. Okay. Now when you look at the question, this might have strike you that the difference between the numerator and denominator is 1 in every case. Okay, the 15 minus 16 is 1, 20 minus 19 is 1, 25 minus 4, 24 is 1, 35 minus 34 is 1. So we will apply the same case which we have applied in question number 1. You can see in question number 1 it was the same question, but the value of fractions are same. The value of fractions are same. The difference is difference is 1 in all cases. Okay, so in this case we will check which fraction has the smallest value. 15 by 16 is the smallest numbers used to form the fraction. So this value will be the smallest one. Okay. So by looking at this kind of questions, you can directly solve these questions in 5 to 10 seconds. Okay, using this trick. Fine. Now let's move to other kind of question wherein the difference is not 1. Okay. This question is if we have to find the smallest fraction among the given fractions. The question has appeared in SEC CGL 24 2002. Okay, now as you can see, the value of the difference between the fractions between the numerator and denominator is not 1. Okay, so this trick cannot be used here. So what we will do is we will use the basic logic which we have talked in start of our lecture. You can see the denominator is same. When the denominator is same, we will compare the numerators. Okay, the numerator which has the biggest value will have the biggest decimal solution, or the answer will be biggest. Okay, so this will be definitely bigger than 7 by 23. So we have to find the smallest one, so we will eliminate this. Okay, one of the option is eliminated. Now we will move to the next 3 1. Okay, now in this one you have 8 by 5 and 7 by 23. Okay, so in 8 by 5 and 7 by 23, when we multiply 8 by 5 by 2 to numerator and denominator, what we get is 16 by 25. Okay, you can see in the denominator the value, the difference is 2. The difference is not much, but in the numerator the difference is of around 9. Okay, so definitely this fraction will be bigger than this fraction. Okay, so we can eliminate this option. Okay, now when we move to the last option, 7 by 23 and 14 by 53, when we apply the same logic, multiply numerator and denominator by 2, 14 and 46. Okay, and 14 by 53. Okay, you can see the numerator is same, but denominator this one is bigger than this. Okay, so what we have said that when the denominator is bigger, the solution will be smaller. So definitely the solution of this will be smaller than this. So this is our answer. So in two to three comparative steps, you can reach to the solution. Okay, without any calculation. Okay, so this is the best part, to know the basics of the maths. Okay, these are the basics of the maths. When you know the basics, the solving of the sums become more easier. Okay, so now we will move to the final and last type, wherein we will try to use all the techniques which we have came to know from the initial questions. Okay, so in this we have to find the greatest fraction among the following. Okay, the fractions are 2 by 3, 5 by 6, 11 by 15 and 7 by 8. Okay, okay, so you can see when we compare the first two fractions, 2 by 3 and 5 by 6, when we multiply both by 2, you will get 4 by 6 and 5 by 6. As the denominator is same, when we compare the numerator, 5 is greater than 4. This is the means the this you can easily make out 5 is greater than 4. So the value of the, as the numerator is bigger, the solution will be bigger. So 5 by 6 will be bigger than 4 by 6. Similarly, when we move to the next question, as 5 by 6 to by 11 by 15, okay. So in this, when you multiply numerator and denominator by 2, okay, you will get 10 by 12 and 11 by 15, okay. So when you you can directly compare, has the numerator and denominator the difference is 1 and the numerator and denominator the difference is 3, okay. So you can directly say that the, here the numerator is bigger and the denominator the difference is 2, but the solution is pretty much closer. So we will try to solve this type of questions with cross multiplication, okay. Here you can see the difference is very much closer, so you cannot take risk at that type of this type of questions, okay. So we will do cross multiplications for 5 by 6 and 11 by 15. 15 into 5 is 75 and 6 into 11 is 66. So you can directly say that this equation is bigger than this. And into 7, 11 by 15 and 7 by 8, when you cross multiply, you will get 5 into 8 into 11, 88 and 15 into 7, 120. Okay. So this is bigger than this. Okay. So you have correlations between all the equations. Only you don't have a correlation between 5 by 6 and 7 by 8. So let's find between them. 5 into 8, 40. 6 into 7 will be around 42. Okay. So this is bigger than this. 42 is bigger than 40. Then we can directly say that 7 by 8 is bigger than rest of the fractions. Okay. So thank you for attending this this web series. And in next web series, we will try to find the smallest and largest fractions of the certs. And if you like the video, please like, subscribe our video. And if you want to know about any government exams like CLAT, SSC CGL, RRB, the details about about the website are mentioned on our website. Our website is www.youngis.com. Do visit our website, and if you like this video or you find this video useful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.